In this episode, let's see how for loop works against var, let, and const variables. Here we have a for loop with var declaration. Var is hoisted to global scope or to the parent function. So we can change this code to something like this. Increment happens at the end of each iteration. So we can move i++ to bottom of the block. One thing to remember here is we have only one I which gets reassigned in each iteration. Now let's see the execution. In the first iteration, I is 0 and check the condition 0 less than 2, which is true. Since it's true, the code inside the block gets executed. We get console log as 0 and I gets incremented to 1 at the end of first iteration. In the second iteration, I is 1 and check the condition I less than 2, which is true. The code inside the block gets executed. We get console log is 1. And I gets incremented to 2 at the end of second iteration. In the next iteration, I is 2 and checks the condition 2 less than 2, which is false, and stop the loop. So the output of this loop is 0 and 1. Let me show you another example. If you put console log after your for loop, it will give 2 as output because var is hoisted and it's not block scope. Let me show you another example. This is one of the famous interview questions. Here it gives 2 times because asynchronous set timeout executes after the loop execution. Meanwhile, the value of I have been changed to 2. Here we have a for loop with let declaration. Let provides a separate I declaration in each iteration, whereas in var we have only one I. Also, increment happens at the start of each iteration except for the first one, whereas in var, increment happens at the end of each iteration. In the first iteration, I is 0 and we don't have i++ in the first iteration. 0 less than 2, which is true. So it enters the block and console log 0. In the second iteration, I is 0 and i++ gives 1. 1 less than 2, which is true. So it enters the block and console log 1. In the next iteration, I is 1 and i++ gives 2. 2 less than 2, which is false, and stops the execution. So the output for this loop is 0 and 1. Let's check the same example of set timeout, but with let. Now it gives 0 and 1 because we got two separate I declarations and it's block scope. Const is similar to let, but with one difference. Let's check. In the first iteration, I is 0 and we don't have i++ in the first iteration. 0 less than 2, which is true. So it enters the block and console log 0. In the next iteration, I is 0 and i++ gives error because we can't change the value of const variables. So it outputs 0 and throws error. And this is how for loop works against var, let, and const. Thank you for watching. Make sure to hit the like and subscribe button. See you in another video.